She got the beat. Ho!
I'm like looking out at all of the amazing people and unicorns and beauty, and it's just fantastic. So thank you all so much for joining us today. I have the amazing honor of having two incredible visionaries, honorees here with me today. Earlier this year in April, we launched The Beauties. It was an initiative to support and honor women and men and all people who are doing amazing things in their communities. Through our partner, Shea Moisture, we hope to empower each and every one of you to create new opportunities, to build and to create experiences that change the world. So to kick things off, I have Tanzania-born model and philanthropist with me today. She's worked with the most respected brands and walked runways for top designers. She was even named one of the 10 black models by Essence Magazine. Please welcome Beauty's honoree and founder of the Flaviana Matata Foundation, Flaviana Matata. Businesswoman, an entrepreneur, a natural hair advocate and activist, the curl expert that is bringing the natural hair game to a whole new level. Please welcome Beauty's honoree and owner of the Miss Rizzo Salon, Carolina Contreras. Great conversation. There's going to be a Q&A at the end, so make sure that you hold your questions. We also have a little bit of a surprise at the end as well. So, Carolina, let's start with you. Everyone's natural hair journey is different. You've been an advocate, you've been leading the charge for so long, and you started Miss Rizzo Salon as a place to celebrate natural hair and do it with love.
Right.
So, tell us, how did you start this all the way from the DR to New York to LA? Talk about your journey.
First of all, I feel like we're in the white table. I feel like Jada Pinkett Smith here. It started as a personal journey. For over 15 years, I relaxed my hair because I thought that that was the right thing to do. I would see, wait, do we have a guest?
Wait a second.
Hello.
Hi, you look stunning. Thank you for joining us. So I don't know if you need an introduction, but I'm going to do one anyways. So jaw-dropping updo, styler, wig maker, entrepreneur extraordinaire, the stylist for Cardi B, Beauty Award honoree, and entrepreneur, Tokyo Styles has graced our stage. Welcome, Tokyo. So we were just talking to Carolina about her natural hair journey. Really, she's been the epitome of natural hair. Started in the DR, New York, LA. Tell us about your journey.
So I was saying that for 15 years, I would look at TV, movies, magazine covers, and not see myself. And I felt that having straight hair was the thing to do. And so finally, when I was like 23, almost 9 years ago, I know I don't look 19, but I'm 32.
Yes, you do, girl. Yes, you do.
I decided to cut all of my hair off because I wanted to embrace every part of me and celebrate what makes me beautiful and who I am. And so I started in the Dominican Republic, my native country, and started a blog. And 3 years into the blog, I opened a salon in Dominican Republic. In April, I announced that we were coming to New York City.
Yay!
And I think BeautyCon is like my omen, my my sort of good luck charm because I'm signing my lease next Thursday.
Yay.
And we're opening up in October, New York City.
Congratulations. That's amazing. It's such an awesome journey to have a vision, to see it grow, and then to be in New York and going back and forth. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
So Flaviana, speaking of beautiful natural hair looks and walking the runway and gracing covers, you were the first Miss Universe pageant, Woo! To compete with a shaved head. The fact that that's even a thing is mind-boggling, but she did it. And now all the work that you do is really highlighting dark skin and a different global standard for beauty. You've really changed the narrative about what it looks like to be beautiful, that it's not bold, it's not new, it's part of life, and that dark skin and shaved heads are, they've really always been here, there's nothing new, but you've really helped shine a light on that and celebrate. So how does your culture, your heritage, kind of inform your work and empower you to be a light for other women?
I think I should say, first of all, where I come from, Tanzania, we have so many cultures, but we don't have anything to do with your skin complexion. It's just we know I'm Tanzanian. They won't say you're white, you're black, you're Indian. It's like we embrace everyone. So I think that has helped me to accept who I am, to be who I am. And I believe there's a beauty of being ourselves. And if being you will empower another, that's a blessing.
Yes, it really is. I think that sometimes we get so caught up in ourselves that we forget to think about being blessed and empowering other people.
And I think the society, especially with social media, there's so much pressure. It's like people are expecting you to be a certain way, especially in the industry that I am, the fashion industry, even beauty, because it's like a client is looking for a certain look, so you think you are not good enough.
Right.
But to be honest, I think it's just good to be you and accept who you are, and then just know that you are not for everyone.
Yeah.
That's right.
You were not, but you were for yourself, and you celebrate yourself. So Tokyo, you,
yes.
Hi. You are famous for not only creating wigs, but modeling them. And a lot of that came from doing it as a necessity. There was lack of models, and now you're truly serving like some of the best, should I say, looks on the internet?
Looks is the correct word to say.
So what does it mean to be able to create and then model your own creations?
For me, what it means to create and able to model my own creations is it's just me being myself and exploring my work and putting it out to the world and just, you know, being me and letting everybody see what I'm capable of. And it just allows me to open up more and, you know, just be more open-minded. I don't know what the word I'm looking for, but you know what I'm saying?
Open-minded, celebrative, it like opens you up to a whole new world and experience.
Yeah, no, it's just, it, for me, it's, I don't know. I just appreciate that people love like what I do and they accept that I am gender fluid, so when I do put the wigs on, people don't look at me crazy or, you know, they don't look down upon me. They, like, accept it and really love, like, what I do. So that's what keeps me going, and that's why I appreciate and I love modeling my own work. So.
Yeah, I think it's interesting. It really is a celebration of inner and outer beauty. We talk at BeautyCon that beauty starts from within. So whenever you can have that confidence and that feeling and celebration, it really makes a difference just in terms of how you see yourself and how others see you. So I want to talk a little bit about the work, Flaviana and Carolina, that you guys are doing. We know that the Crown Act, just passed in Los Angeles. The Crown Act, really championed by Dove, is on a mission to help stop discrimination against natural hair. And you all have been doing a lot of work in that space. Not only are girls being denied access to education and workplaces across the world, but you all are really committed in your communities to stopping that. So can you talk about some of the injustices, the access that's being denied, and more importantly, what you're doing to support it? Do you want to?
Sure. So in my country, the Dominican Republic, a lot of workspaces and a lot of universities and schools actually don't allow little girls and women to go with their curly hair, which is absurd. And one of the things that we did is that we started a comic book. So they turned me into a superheroine because there aren't superheroes that look like me. So I became one. And that comic book shares the constitutional laws that protect all Dominicans against discrimination on the basis of race and hair. And so we've just distributed over 7,000 of these comic books completely for free all around the country. We have it online, people download it, and they use it not only as a tool to see themselves in a superhero, but to also be educated on the laws that protect their rights.
That's amazing. We have a real superhero here that's champion and changing the world. It's amazing. It's like you have to reach and educate people where they are. So that's extremely smart.
Like Toni Morrison said, you know, may she rest in power, that you have to create what's not out there, you know? And so there wasn't this, and so we created it. And I would love to kind of send that message out, that if you want to do something that doesn't exist, you can do it.
Definitely. I think that that's a powerful message for all of us. I mean, look here at BeautyCon. If it doesn't exist, create it and define a moment that's going to forever change the world. So that's amazing. And Flaviana, I know that you're doing so much work to help girls and to help young women. How does that connect with your country, your community, and just society?
I think for me, it was more of seeing a need. I got scouted to do modeling. And I had an option to either continue school or pursue modeling as a career after I graduated from college. But I thought about those young girls in Tanzania, they just want to go to school, but they don't have an option because they are coming from underserved communities. And that's where Flaviana Matata Foundation started. We initially started by providing scholarship to these girls to go to school. Later on, we started providing school supplies, and we're now renovating school infrastructure because some schools are called school, but girls are learning under the tree. Later on, as we are visiting school, I think like everyone knows, it's like a lot of girls are missing up to 5 days of school when they're on their periods, only because they don't have access to sanitary pads. So this October, I'm launching my own sanitary pad line.
Wow, congratulations.
And the proceeds will go to support all the wash projects in schools, and we'll be able to supply free sanitary pads to a couple of schools that we are working with. I think this is aligned with all the mission, because in everything that we are doing, we are trying to give every girl an opportunity. And I think using education it's just a platform, because you're not only changing these girls' lives, but the generation to come.
Exactly. I mean, I think it's not just about changing lives, but also looking at the future generation. Like, what are we doing now that's going to impact the people that are coming along before us? And what are the things that we're seeing in society that we can take a hold of and act on? And I love that, because we talk about it, but we don't necessarily, we're not about it. We're not being.
And I always tell people, I think it's just start with one. Yeah. Look around you and see what the need is. Even if you are just helping one person, that might be your cousin, your niece, your neighbor. It's just you're changing lives. So I think it's each one's responsibility to give back and make this world a better place for everyone.
Yes, definitely. Thank you. And Tokyo, I want to kind of switch. I mean, you're changing lives and making the world a better place through your creativity. And you really learned at a young age, like, how to do your hair, your sister's hair every day. And it's like, at that point, you didn't know that you would be here creating something so emotional and so personal. And you're making styles for Cardi and Kylie, and it's just phenomenal. So was working with hair always a creative outlet for you? Like, what was the impetus of that?
Working with hair was a creative outlet. Like, I've always been, like, super artsy and, like, into just creating and, you know, just using my mind to create different things. I didn't realize that I was really good with hair, though, like, until my mom, you know, she was incarcerated, and I started taking care of my sister while she was gone. And that's when I just was like, wow, like, I'm really killing this. This is, like, crazy. Like, literally, the first time I did her hair, I literally was doing cornrows. Like, Alicia Keys. Remember the Alicia Keys braid?
Yes,
that was
yes,
the first style I did on her with the little over-the-ear thing and the beads. Everything. It was crazy. But, you know, I've just always been, you know, into the art thing, and hair did. It's like therapy, too, for me, especially now when I am just, you know, need to take my mind off something, or when I'm just, like, super stressed. Being creative and stuff like that just kind of like eases my mind and makes me more relaxed. And then I feel better because I know I just created something that's probably going to be the next trend. So,
I mean, that's, it's amazing. It's also such a big responsibility. You're like, I'm creating trends.
Yeah.
And it's really interesting because not only are you creating trends, but you were redefining the way that people feel about themselves through their hair. It's passionate. It's personal. So, you know, what does it mean to you to help shape the way that someone else feels about themselves through what you've done creatively?
For me, that's like one of the biggest things that I really like. Like, after I do somebody's hair and to see their reaction and just how confident they feel. And, you know, it's literally like they're a whole new person. Like, they sit all up and like everything changes.
Changes everything.
And just to see that, is, to me, it's amazing that just one simple hairstyle can like change your whole life and make somebody, change somebody else's life, I should say, and make them feel more confident about themselves. So
it's true. It's like you wake up and as soon as your hair's done, it doesn't matter what's happening, you instantly feel better, like you're gonna conquer the world. And it's amazing.
As soon as it's messed up, that confidence goes right back down.
And then you start all over again. So we talked about the beauties, our first ever beauty awards that happened in New York with our partner Shea Moisture. And there's three tenets of the beauties that really everyone, each of you, embody. It's redefining beauty. We've talked about, what does beauty look like? How can you be the first at something? How can you bring a new trend, a new style to life? Celebrating self-expression. It's not just about being dark skin or being gender neutral. It's really about, how do you express yourself that makes you and everyone around you feel confident and passionate? And it's also about creating community. You look around here, 30,000 people are coming into this convention center. We've created a community of people who not just care about beauty, but care about each other. So talk about the ways that you guys have created communities that have helped you move forward in your life and your careers.
For me, social media has been super important. But one of the things that I like to do is to meet my followers face to face. So I do a lot of meet and greets. And just last weekend in New York City, where I now live temporarily, I announced it like on a Sunday night. I'm like, let's meet at the park and have picnic, like a very informal meeting. And, you know, over 100 people show up the next Saturday, and we're all there with food, and everybody like brought food to share with other people, and we're just there chilling, talking. And I think that removing sort of the digital and the social media aspect of things and meeting people face to face is something that we should be doing, because I think that it expands our community and it allows us to touch the people that support us, people like us, more. And so that's how I sort of foster the community, is by doing face-to-face activations and experiences.
It's amazing, because people think that social media, which it's been positive because it connects us to people all over the world, but nothing beats like an in real life experience, IRL,
like
touching, and meeting each other.
You know, just a tight hug and sharing that vibe and that energy for me is super, super important.
It is, it is. And Tokyo, community. I mean, you have built such an amazing group of followers and supporters. Like, what does community mean to you? How did you create that?
For me, community is, I like to give back. Like, I get so much. I think it's important to give back to those who support you as well. So, like, when I can do something, or I do have something that I can give away, or, like, wig giveaways or anything, like, I first started doing wigs when one of my friends, she had a cancer organization. I wasn't looking for money. I just wanted to help people. So I started making wigs for cancer patients who were going through chemo and all that. So for me, it's just giving back and, you know.
I think that's the best part about community. How do you give, take, and support each other all along the way? And I think that that's what makes it so special, that you can have your creativity and your craft, but you can also say, how do I give back? How do I support those around me? Mm-hmm. And Flaviana, you've created an amazing community, not just as a model, as an entrepreneur, as an activist, but just a community of people that you are empowering. How did you create that? What does community mean to you?
I think it's super important, especially coming from Tanzania. It's like I was raised with a community by a single parent, but of course I had my uncles, my aunties, so community in Tanzania is not something new, so I grew up seeing that, and it was such an easy thing to do when I started my organization. Some people think what I'm doing is new, but actually it's a continuation of what my dad used to do when we were little. He did not only educate, give education to make sure we are getting educated, but also our cousin and other people around us. So it built a sense of community somehow. And through Lavi, I think some of people might know that I have a nail polish line. In Tanzania, the nail industry is dominated by male. And we wanted to change that. We are not only selling nail polishes to saloons, but we started like educating young girls and women who want to get into the nail industry how to do nails and start their own nail business. So it's just sometimes when you are giving back, you don't know if you are building a community, but I think that's the easiest way I've been able to build my community, because a lot of people are not following me actually as a model is because of the work that I'm doing back home in Tanzania.
I think that's the thing that we will take with us outside of the modeling and everything that we're doing now, is like, how does your community expand beyond that one thing? And that's phenomenal. And I'm getting my nails done.
Like, nice.
So now we're going to do something new. I'm going to stand up for this because it's actually never happened on the BeautyCon stage before. We're going to play a fun game. I have the BeautyCon box. And there's some amazing things inside. So each of my honorees are going to pull. And we're going to do some rapid fire questions. Who's going? Tokyo, you were here later. I got to start with you. Okay. Tell us. What's
New York or LA? Definitely LA.
Why?
I'm a LA girl. Like, New York is just too fast paced. There's too much going on. No disrespect to anybody from New York, but it reeks of smell. Like,
oh no, Carolina's like, I just moved
I'm
there.
I'm sorry, but like, I don't.
I
it's just
agree.
Too much for me. I can't. The transportation, the buses, taxi. It's just too many people. I get like claustrophobic and like anxiety. Like, I can't do it.
All right, LA all the way. LA all the way. Okay, let's see.
What is one trend that has definitely passed, but that you still hold on to?
Oh, like culottes.
Everything kind of comes back. Like,
yeah, it does.
Bell bottom jeans. I still rock them.
I
never
yesterday.
Stop. Yeah, everything just kind of circles back.
And the music too. It all comes back around.
All of it.
Okay.
Easy. How many hours of sleep a night do you need to be at your best?
Ooh.
At least 6 hours.
Six?
Otherwise, six? It's like I'm going to be moody.
To be in my bed.
Yeah. Six to 8 hours is good. More than 8 hours is like too much to me.
8 hours is too much. Okay, Tokyo, what is it?
Huh?
How many hours of sleep?
I need a lot of sleep because I get real cranky. So, but I really don't get a lot of sleep. That's the thing, though. But if I can, I will sleep all day.
Nice. We'll be cozied up with you. Okay, we're going to go around. We have time for another round. Okay.
Early bird or night owl, when is your most productive time of day?
Ooh.
Definitely a night person. I hate getting up. As you see, that's why I was a little late. I'm most, like, I work really late most of the time. Like, I'll be up at, like, 2 o'clock in the morning making wigs and, like, just up. Until, like, the sun comes up, then I want to go to sleep.
And you're like, okay, I'm done. I'm
yeah, I'm,
done.
Like, nocturnal or something.
We'll remember that. Okay.
Who has been the most influential person in your life? My college professor, Reverend Rice, who passed 2 years ago, I feel like I have a little bit of him in me, and my activism and everything I dedicate to him.
Oh, that's amazing. It's so great when you have people in your life and you're just like, here's why and here's how. And I feel like they come in and out whenever you need them. Okay.
What is one trend you're taking shape that excites you? I'm not a trendy person, so I always wear or buy what works for me, because I believe trends comes and go.
Yeah.
I always have to collect pieces that I can wear throughout the years, so I'm not a trendy person.
I know, that's kind of what you said. That's how we all feel. Okay, who's going to do the last one? Tokyo.
Why me? Because you came late. I'm just kidding.
What's one thing you think the beauty industry should be talking about right now that they're not?
Ooh,
that's
a good
one. How good I look in this yellow dress.
Yeah.
One thing that I think that they should be talking about, geez, it's a lot. I don't know. We just need more like self-love and just supporting each other. And, you know, it's enough room for everybody to make it. It's enough money for us all. Like, there's no reason to be, you know, jealous and hating on the next girl that's coming right behind you doing the same thing. So I just think more support and, you know, empowering others to, you know, there's more room for everybody. Like, we can all make it. So
there's room for everybody. Thank you. It's so true. So we are going to turn it into audience Q&A. Right? Oh, am I supposed to do that? I think here he comes right here. Oh, go ahead.
Her mic ain't on.
Hi, so I know that you guys like faced a lot of challenges going through everything that you guys needed to get through to get where you guys are today. So I was wondering, what gave you guys motivation when you guys felt like the road was against you when you guys were reaching your goals?
So one of my mottos is to do it afraid. A lot of times I think we spend so much time trying to eliminate fear from our lives, self-doubt, insecurities. And I stand here, or I sit here in front of you, scared and nervous, but still here. And I think showing up for myself every time and telling fear, hey, what's up, what's good, you can hang out, but you're not gonna paralyze me and stop me from doing what I want to do and from living my truth and walking in my power.
Exactly. I mean, you're the epitome of that. You left the DR after starting a successful salon to go to New York to do it all over again. It's like we stamp down fear, we stand in our faith, and we march forward. It's amazing. Does anyone else want to answer that? This little girl's next.
Over here. So as a young African American girl, I like to wear my hair straight and only straight. So how can I like embrace my curls?
Ooh.
A question for
That's
you,
a
sis.
Good question.
First of all, I think that looking at yourself in the mirror and understanding that you are beautiful just the way you are, regardless of how your hair looks. I always say that you define your hair doesn't define you. And you can wear your hair straight and feel beautiful with it straight, and wear it curly and feel beautiful with it curly. But know that you're doing it for yourself and not because society is imposing this idea of a standard of beauty of how you should look like. And you are absolutely beautiful.
That's fantastic. Thank you. Another question? Yes.
Oh, me.
She need a microphone.
Me?
Hi, oh, we see you.
Oh, okay. Okay, my question is for Tokyo. So for me, I define success as when opportunity meets preparation, and obviously where you are now, you've mastered that. I wanted to know, how did you create all those amazing opportunities to work with Cardi, Kylie? Just how did you put yourself in that position?
Well, a lot of it was word of mouth. My first celebrity client was Keisha Cole, and I feel like once you get one and you, like, kill it, your name is just going to start to travel, and people are going to wonder who you are and, like, you know, what you do and what you're capable of. But social media was my major way of, like, how I connected to almost everybody's hair that I've done. So many people, when I ended up doing their hair, they were like, oh, I've been watching you for the past 6 months, but they weren't following me. So, like, just always be cautious of what you post, because you just never know who's watching you and, like, stuff like that. But social media is, like, what helped me connect to all those people that I work with.
So we've had an amazing panel, an amazing time kicking off BeautyCon. I think that we want you all to walk away knowing that you can redefine beauty. You can celebrate yourself and self-expression. You can create your own community. You can do anything and everything that you want to. And we want you all to know that we believe in you, that we want you to believe in each other, and that beauty does not define you. You define everything about you. So thank you. Happy BeautyCon Festival. And we'll see you soon.
Bye.